Really is great. You know, I've wanted to come here forever. I've never been here on a film, so it's really exciting. Well, hopefully they'll like it. I don't, you know, I mean, you make things with the hope that connects to some people. And you know, I've been lucky. You know, even if it connects with just a few people, it's a really nice thing. So hopefully they just enjoy the emotion of the story and all the monsters. Well, I mean, it's basically for those reasons. I grew up in Burbank, which, you know, suburban, middle class, and death was a very taboo subject. Nobody would discuss it. But again, there being such a large Hispanic population there, you know, I get a lot of my, I just thought, well, this is such a positive way to be exploring these themes. And it's the humor and the imagery and the color and all of that. I just said, you know, here in our life, we don't talk about it. It's a taboo subject. But there, it's like, it's to me, it's the most positive way of presenting or dealing with that issue. And I that's why I love it. I always have. Oh, absolutely. I mean, when I was a kid, on Saturday afternoon television, they would show, I don't know why, because they were probably cheap. They got all these, like, you know, like Mexican horror films and then dubbed them really badly into English. But it gave it a weird kind of vibe, charm to it, too. Which, and some of them were really striking. I mean, some of the like, 60s and the horror stuff was really, really good. You know, I like, they were very memorable. They were like weird dreams, you know, and to see something like that on TV, you know, in mid-afternoon was just very, you know, very memorable. You know, I'd love to do a Mexican horror, wrestling horror film. Absolutely. It's a film, you know. I mean, the idea of doing it in reality does not hold a lot of appeal to me. You know, what, you know, in a film, obviously, it's like a wish fulfillment fantasy kind of thing. But in real life, I don't think I would, you know, bring my dead dog back to life, you know. Well, I've been very lucky in my whole life because the first short film I did, Vincent, was about Vincent Price, and I sent it to him. And he narrated the film, you know, and so, and then I've, you know, I'm lucky enough to, another influence was this animator, Ray Harryhausen, who did all these, and I met him, and that, and Christopher Lee, who's somebody who I loved growing up, and met him, and worked. So I've been very lucky to meet and sometimes work with people that have inspired you, and that's, I'll tell you, it's such a nice thing to have happen, you know, especially at the beginning of your career. When see, I don't think there's any other project that I have that I would consider that. Also, just, you know, the short film was live action. This, you know, and I love stop motion, so it just felt like this was a more pure version because it kind of went back to the original drawings, and stop motion technique kind of goes in line with the Frankenstein bringing an inanimate object to life, you know. So it made a lot more sense and a lot more personal, and like with the other kids and the teachers and actually even the look of places, the neighborhood, the classroom, all of that was based on real memories. And I don't see any other project like that I've done in the past or would have that same appeal to me. Well, I try not to think too much about it. I mean, you know. You know, like I said, I of all the cultures I've visited and been to, I find the Mexican dealing with it is the most positive way I can of any culture I've ever been to. I don't know. I mean, I never felt like I connected to, you know, and any time I did a film, I never knew if it would be successful or failure. I never had any. I still don't. You know, I. The films could have easily just been successful or failure, each one of them, you know. So you don't really, I never really thought of myself in terms of like knowing how to talk to people or whatever, you know. And as an animator, I really, you know, I didn't speak much at all, so I had to. Look, that's my then. That's been my history. I've come and gone from Disney like 5 times. I left after Frankenweenie. I came back. I left after Ed Wood. Then I came back, and I left after Nightmare. So
and now Nightmare is part of
Alice. And then so I mean I've yeah. Hired and fired many times. I'm used to it.
And now Nightmare is part of the Disney parks.
I know. It's crazy. It is crazy. I mean, that just shows you how crazy the world is, you know. It's amazing. Yeah.
Grupo Presente Multimedios. Evolución, comunicación, compromiso.